Hey everyone, welcome back to Design News. Today we're checking out some amazing Figma updates, which will kind of change the way you design inside Figma. An amazing file management plugin, which will allow you to manage files and assets inside your Figma files, which is kind of crazy. A web-based tool which allows you to remove objects, any object, from an image without using Photoshop or anything else. Also an update to spline tool, which allows you to create 3D glass animations, and that you can add to your Figma, XD, whatever tool you like. All this and so much more in today's episode of Design News. So make sure you watch till the end and also subscribe to the channel before you move on. All right, so the first news comes from a design friend of mine called Nitish. Bookmark is a plugin that he's created recently, and it's crazy because it allows you to link different Figma files and put it into one organized folder or multiple organized folders. So for example, you're working on FigJam and you have a design file connected with it. You can have those files in one folder so that you can go back and forth between each other. Not only that, you can add inspiration links. So if you have, say, a dribble link, you can always bookmark that dribble link and associate it with a particular file. That way you will be able to create organized mood boards right inside Figma. And yes, everything can be organized under folders. So you can have an onboarding folder and you can put all your onboarding screens and files into that. And what if you want to send this organized files to a friend of yours or to a colleague of yours? Well, you can do that. There's something called backup and export. So it will export a file which then can be imported by the bookmark plugin on your friend's or colleague's Figma. That way you can stay organized together. Also, if this seems a little confusing, don't worry. There is an explanation GIF or video here, which kind of explains what can be done and how to do it here on the very website he's created. Now, if you're a designer, chances are you've heard about Bravo Studio. I did a couple of videos, so if you want to learn more about it, go check that out later. But Bravo Studio version 3 is out, which will enable you to create such extensive and incredible apps without using code. Just design and an app comes out. Apart from that, it allows you to create a draft version of an app as well as a live version of an app. So if you're working on some changes, you can make it to the draft, and once it's live, you can push it to live. You now have the ability to connect a lot more applications and APIs. So you can basically connect things like Notion, Webflow, WordPress, OpenAPI, which is kind of crazy and will give you a lot of benefits. Also, you can add Auth 2, which is a very safe version of authentication for your application. So you can basically allow people to register, login, without having the hassle of protection and safety. And they have maps available now, so you can add a map by default and then add places on it and give a map capabilities. So if you want to build a version of Google Maps, why not? Go ahead. We all remember and have used Spline tool at some point of time. They now have a crazy new update which allows you to add glass. Yes, the whole frosted glass look that everyone is in love with and is amazed with is incredible, because now it is by default there in the spline tool. You just have to select color and change it to glass. And it's as simple as that. Over that, you can add textures, create that frosted glass look that everyone loves, and also add animations, 3D and more, and also add things like lighting effects, animations, and so much more to that. So the whole glassmorphic look is gonna get a huge upgrade with spline tool. Again, there are videos on spline on my channel as well, so go check that out. But glass is a huge update and I love it. Now, in other news, Anima is one of the best plugins for XD, Figma, and Sketch. However, they have now a new update which brings it to the next level. First of all, it brings truly functional material design, which means all the ripple buttons and input fields, sliders and buttons and stuff like that, all will be included in Anima. So all you'll need to do is just drag and drop from Anima and all the functionality will be attached to it. Another crazy feature is that there is something called widgets now. So if you want to add a button to, say, your prototype, before adding it, you can edit the text, the button type, the layout of the button, the effects of the button, the icon of the button, if you want an icon inside the button. All that can be done in widgets and then be added to your Figma or XD. And it also brings something called parallax scroll for Adobe XD. So now you can add parallax scroll almost natively in XD. You just have to click a button and an object or a scene will turn into a parallax object. And then when you scroll, it has this nice parallax animation. Fingers crossed should be coming to Figma soon. Now you've all used tools like remove BG, which allows you to remove the background from a subject in an image. But what if I told you now you can remove objects from inside an image and still keep the original image? Now this is really possible because of cleanup.pictures. Now this uses AI and a bunch of other tech to bring this thing to life. And I'll show you an example to show you how amazing this works. Now here is an image where there's a lot of depth of field, which means behind the glass, you can see things have started to blur out and fade away. So you'd assume covering up this glass or removing this glass from this image will be difficult. Well, not for this tool. I'm going to download this image. Once I've downloaded this, I'm going to just drag and drop. That's as simple. I can change the brush size, but for now, this is fine. And all I need to do is just paint around, first of all, this object. And once I've painted around this, I can paint inside it as well. That's about it. Just remove your mouse from there. And within a few seconds, it's going to remove this cup or this mug. Wow, okay, so this almost keeps the depth of field effect where the things are starting to blur out. Ask yourself this question, guys. If I had this image in front of you, would you think I've removed something from this? Would you think I've edited it in any way like this? No. So it shows how it can even remove objects from complex images where there's depth of field or where there's a blurred background or a foreground object. Just to see how well this works, I'm going to download this other image where there's this little hen and this vase here. Drag this pencil or pen, whatever you want to call it, over this hen. It will magically just disappear and it will keep all the background objects, the table, everything intact. Oops. Okay, so we did mess up a little bit, but as a final touch, you can brush it again. And if I brush it again, within seconds, wow, it has removed the hen. Look at this. Does it feel like there was a hen statue before this? To me, it doesn't. If I had shown you this picture, you would think it's a normal picture of a vase and nothing else. As some of you know, I have my own design school where we train students and get them placed in some incredible companies like Accenture, Tata Consultancy, Lollipop Design, and other amazing companies. We've recently launched a job guarantee program as well. Along with that, we're having a new batch in November 20th. So if you want to know more about this and even join the program for a very affordable price, you can do that. You just have to follow the link, go to Join Design Wings, and after you fill out this form, we'll give you a call back. One of our team members will get back to you and solve all your questions there. Now, this is a news for tomorrow and for the coming 2-3 days. This is called Adobe Max. All these incredible folk like Conan O'Brien out of the blue are gonna be here, and they're gonna showcase all the incredible updates as well as new tools Adobe will release this year. You'll have Photoshop updates, Illustrator updates, and surprise, surprise, Adobe XD updates. I'm really eager for this update because I've been waiting and there seems to be a lot of hype behind this. So if you want to check out Adobe Max, I suggest go check it out and sign up, register for free before tomorrow so you don't miss out on these incredible Max sessions. I will try to cover most of the updates on the channel, so subscribe to the channel and wait for it as well. Yeah, I know everybody's been waiting for the Figma updates that is going to change everything. Now, the first Figma update, which I'm really happy about, is FigJam. FigJam's new update allows you to add widgets, plugins, and widgets to your whiteboard, essentially. So now you'll have crazy widgets like polls, color selectors, chat bubbles, and windows, and all these crazy things inside FigJam. So FigJam is now the ultimate tool, apparently. And I've been using FigJam for a while to brainstorm with my team on Design Wings. And to be honest, it's actually pretty helpful. Now with some crazy widgets that the community is coming up with, the possibilities have become endless. And I'm really excited to see where this goes, especially with GPT-3. Now you can even use FigJam without a Figma account. Yes, so if you're doing, say, an event or a session with people, all right, and they don't have a Figma account, no worries. They can join your Jam open session. And in this open session, this file will only be active for 24 hours unless you decide to separately save it somewhere. So you'll essentially have this nice mood board or dashboard where you can just brainstorm with people just for 24 hours, even if they don't use Figma. Thank God, because a lot of product managers will not use Figma, a lot of developers won't use Figma, and if they have access to such tools without having an account, kudos to you, Figma. They're finally making some beta features public. Yes, thank God. The whole merging different design iterations into one is now live so that anybody can use this. Since we're talking about Figma now, warp tools. Yes, this is a really cool plugin which allows you to warp shapes, text, anything basically, and you can warp it freely. You can warp it around a radius, use strength. Kind of reminds me of certain tools in Illustrator and Photoshop, which allows you to do the same. However, this is now in Figma. Go ahead, leave Photoshop and Illustrator for Figma now, huh? No, I'm just kidding. Adobe, please don't sue me. Now, figuring out the best illustrations for your project is kind of tricky because there is dark mode, light mode, different kinds and styles of illustrations, but you never know what fits well. Doodle Ipsum, of course, from Blush by Pablo Stanley, is one such tool that allows you to do that. You can choose between different kinds of avatars and design styles from here, and it changes on the right. They also have different parameters. So if you want the background of an illustration to be this round circle, then you can add a particular parameter called shape is equal to circle in your code, and that's it. This Blush API is kind of going to change the game when it comes to adding illustrations, almost dynamic illustrations, to your projects. Is that a new tech we're coming up with? Kudos to Pablo for this amazing, incredible API and this tool that he has live here. Coding good illustrations, designs, and resources is difficult because there's so many different kinds of assets out there. UI Score, however, makes it easier for you. It kind of feels like any other design library, illustration library, similar to UI 8. But where it differentiates itself is by creating this tool called Create Pull Builder. It allows you to access various illustrations in its library and then mix and match them. So you can add an illustration from one library and add one from another, combine them and make your own. Crazy thing is, you can even select things like the action the person is doing. So running, standing, walking, whatever you want, the illustration can do that for you. An office background with a child crying in front. Bring your child to work day, apparently. And yes, it's called embed ready here as well. You can just embed these illustrations and dynamically change it later on your website. I think it's pretty cool, to be honest. So the Illustrator Builder for Figma and Sketch is completely free. If you want complete access to themes, commercial use, branding assets, UI kits, everything in one, they have a full access portion where, of course, you pay a small amount and you can get all their entire library for a certain amount. And I will see you next time. Same place, same time, every Monday and Thursday. Remember that. Subscribe to the channel, click on the bell icon, and like the video if you did like the video. I'll see you next time. Till then, take care. God bless.